the time has come.
At the moment, we are nearly a few days away from NASCAR's playoff field being set at the Daytona International Speedway. Right now, there will be 15 drivers vying for one final spot in the top 16. There are two drivers who can currently make it in off of points and or winning. Those others that are outside of those two can only make it off of winning. So, the man who currently is in the 16th spot right now is Tyler Reddick. At the moment, Reddick is 25 points into the postseason. If neither he or Austin Dillon scores stage points, he needs to be 25 positions or less near the 3 car. If Dillon doesn't win, that is. Basically, just keep the 3 from winning and be within 25 points of him. As for Dillon, he needs to do the exact opposite. He needs to score 25 or more points than his teammate and or just plain win. It's certainly possible to get enough points and stage points, but that's still going to be a pretty tough task. Now, overall, let's be real. A lot of these drivers are going to have to just go for wins. Really, every one of these drivers has to go for wins, let's be honest. So, let's briefly look back at what these drivers' pasts can show us for how well they can perform on Saturday night. What I'll do is look back at when we had the change to the relatively current Super Speedway package back in 2019 at Talladega, all the way through to today. And we'll also look at the Daytona finishes too. So let's go and look at each driver. Starting with Tyler Reddick. Reddick is very hit or miss at the Super Speedways. He's never finished above 27th at Daytona. While he has finished 7th twice at Talladega, that really doesn't help in this regard. I think that Reddick winning this race is a tall task. He'll have a fast enough car, it's just a matter of if he stays out of enough trouble. Next up, we have Austin Dillon. While he's had great moments at Super Speedways in the past, the last 2 years or so have been pretty rough for the driver of the three. But this year so far has been pretty good. He finished 3rd in the 500 and 8th at Talladega, and this really continued a trend of improvement over the past couple of races at Super Speedways. And in 2019, he even ran in the top 10 there as well. So I think that Dillon could be a relatively strong threat to get a win this. So I do think Dillon could be a relatively strong threat to get a win this weekend. Next up is Matt DiBenedetto. DiBenedetto is another driver who really could get a win, has the speed to get a win, but probably won't. When you look back at his past during the Super Speedway package's stint, he has had good runs. An 8th in 2019 at Daytona was one that was really good, as well as kind of blowing a win away this year at Talladega. But that doesn't mean DiBenedetto is going to be running up front. He's had plenty of races that have been 25th or 30th or worse. So it's not to say that he's going to be, by any stretch of the imagination, a favorite for this weekend. Next up is Chris Buescher. Buescher is a driver who so far this year has struggled in his first two Super Speedway starts. But when you look at his past, especially 2020, he has run exceptionally fast. Then you also add in the fact that Roush Fords are pretty good at these tracks, and you gotta say that Buescher could be a threat. I mean, last year he finished 3rd, 6th, and 9th in 3 of the 4 Super Speedway races. So who's to say he can't turn his luck around this year? Next up is Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Stenhouse's main success at Super Speedways came under a vastly different package, so I think you can't really add too much of that to what we see here. When you look at the past 2 years or so of his performances, he has run either hit or miss. A 2nd at Dega in 2020 is pretty good, as well as a 9th in 2019, but the other finishes are pretty mediocre and bad. 25th, 24th, 20th, 32nd, 18th, and 33rd. So I don't think Stenhouse is someone who is a gung-ho guaranteed favorite the way that a lot of people are saying he is. I think that he's just someone who has the potential to do good, but probably won't. Ross Chastain is the next one up. When you look at his past at Super Speedways, it's kind of hard to judge. After all, he's run with a myriad of different teams, and really, this past year is the only one we can really judge on. Well, he's actually done well at keeping his car out of trouble for the most part. He finished 7th in the Daytona 500 and 16th at Talladega. He didn't crash out of either of those, which for Chastain is saying something. So, I think that Chastain, if he can keep his equipment together, could be someone who is in position to win, similar to that of Michael McDowell at the Daytona 500 this past year. Next up in points is Bubba Wallace. Now, if you listen to a lot of people, Bubba Wallace could be one of the favorites this weekend. But I don't think that's as much the case. Yes, he has run in the top 5 as recently as 2020 at Daytona, but at the same time, he's also had finishes of 39th, 24th, 24th again, and then a lot of 15th place finishes. So I really don't think that Bubba is somebody who might just go out there and dominate, but he did run well during the duels, so there is the possibility. I think Bubba's another driver who may be like a Michael McDowell and at least be in position to win at the end of the day. Behind Bubba in points is Chase Briscoe. Now, Briscoe's a rookie this year, so there's not really much data to go off of. He finished 19th in the 500 and 11th at Talladega. Though he has had momentum on his side, I don't think that's really going to translate much to Daytona. If he keeps his car together, that should be a success. Do I think he'll win? Not a chance. Erik Jones is the driver up next. While I do want to think that he could run up front, after all, he's in a car that ran up front last year, and he's a pretty talented super speedway racer, statistics don't show that much. When you look back at his time under this package, he has a lot of finishes below 30th, and plenty more below 20th. Though he has a 5th and a 2nd place finish at the 2 Talladega races last year, that really doesn't translate much to Daytona this year. So Jones is someone who, probably due to just the horrible luck he has in his career, will probably be caught up in an accident or something. Next up is the one who I think is least likely to win this Saturday night, Daniel Suarez. Well, why is that? Well, maybe because since his 12th place finish at Talladega in 2019's spring race, he has failed to really finish above the 20th position. I mean, listen to these finishes. 40th, 32nd, missed the Daytona 500, 28th, 26th, 34th, 36th, 23rd. Not really the recipe for success. The next guy up in the points is someone who is all too familiar with the Daytona International Speedway, and that is Ryan Newman. And when you look at his time under this similar package, I'd say it's one of Jekyll and Hyde. Look at 2019. He finished 7th, 5th, and 2nd with this package, and then turned around with a 9th place finish in the 2020 Daytona 500. Of course, nobody remembers that for where he finished as much as for how he finished there. Well, after that happened, he has since only had one top 10 and has finished 24th, 36th, 38th, and 13th in the other races. So, Newman will probably have the speed to run up front, but seems like his luck has run out. Now, underneath Newman is Ryan Preece. And when you look at Preece's career, you'd be surprised to see how many good moments he's had at the super speedways. After all, he finished 3rd at Talladega in 2019. He also finished in the top 10 at Dega in 2020, and in the Daytona 500, he finished 6th, along with finishes of 14th at 2021 in Talladega and 15th at the same track in 2020. So, it's not to say that there isn't a chance that he could actually be up there, but it is a long shot. But Preece has better shots than I think a lot of other people do. Now, underneath Preece is the last driver who's in a car that many would say, quote-unquote, is competitive, and that is Cole Custer. In his rookie year, Custer was pretty atrocious at these tracks, getting a 22nd place finish, and then 3 finishes at 30th or worse. But this year so far, he's remained in contention. He's also remained out of trouble, finishing 11th in the Daytona 500 and 10th at Talladega. So, I think Cole Custer could stay out of trouble and maybe luck his way into a win. Who knows? In the 29th spot in points, I think we have the ultimate underdog this week who could actually pull off the win. That is Corey LaJoie. Now, you might be sitting there kind of puzzled why I think Corey LaJoie has a better shot than any of these other drivers, and it's because he just always manages to get up front at these tracks. Doesn't matter the car, doesn't matter the make, doesn't matter the situation. He had 2 top 10s in these races in 2019. He had another one in the 500 last year, and he finished 9th in the Daytona 500 this year. So, if Peeps out of trouble. Maybe the reins hit at a certain point, or maybe that team just has a little more speed. Corey LaJoie could get his playoff waiver all the way into the playoffs. Now, our last but not least driver is Fast Pasta, Anthony Alfredo. And unfortunately for Alfredo, there's really not much to say. He's run pretty mid-pack to low-pack all the year. He's a rookie this year, so he doesn't have much data on him. And that data we do have on him is sporadic and erratic. So he's finished 32nd at the 2021 Daytona 500 and 12th at Talladega. That 12th is pretty good, but it also is definitely not because he was dominant enough to get a win. So I've given my thought on each driver from 16th to 30th in points. Now I'm going to give my prediction. What three drivers do I think are most likely to make the playoffs? Well, number one, Austin Dillon. I think Dillon could make it off of either winning or just running up front. After him, Ryan Preece. Preece is a surprisingly good drafter. He keeps out of trouble, he's always up front, and I think that he could manage to get the win. And then I talked a big game about my third place guy in this list, Corey LaJoie. Again, doesn't matter what he's in, he always manages to get to the front. So I think he has a good shot. My honorable mention for this would definitely have to be Tyler Reddick. He's got the point lead. He's got a bit of a cushion. The only problem is he's not too great at Daytona. But if he just has a mediocre finish and nobody new wins, he'll make the playoffs no problem. Now, that's all from me. Now I want to hear from you. What driver do you think is going to have that final playoff spot? Let me know down in the comments below. While you're at it, leave a like in this video, share this video, and subscribe to my channel for more great NASCAR content. Also, thank you to all of the members of my channel. I really, really appreciate your generosity. Now, until next time, have a good one.